If you live in the United States, you've probably heard of The Tonight Show starring Jimmy Fallon, where they feature an interactive segment called Hashtags, where they post a hashtag and then they pick the top 10 contributors to that hashtag and feature them on The Tonight Show. This week, Jimmy posted to use 6 words to describe college and tag it with college in 6 words. So he went first, $80,000 for a hat you wear once, and then people started contributing and using the hashtag. If he likes what you had to say, he'll feature your tweet and your username on his show to an audience of millions. Well, I sure love free publicity, so I was wondering, what does it take to get featured on The Tonight Show? How does The Tonight Show staff pick the winners that they feature every week? To figure out how to get picked, I decided to put myself in their shoes and look at the competition and try to figure out how The Tonight Show staff pick the winning tweets. So my first question is, well, how many of these people posted with that hashtag for this week? Are we talking thousands or hundreds of thousands? And is there something about the winners that maybe is out of my control? Like, do they just pick the top liked tweets and that's it? To figure this out, I needed the raw data behind the tweets. So I used the Steve C. Data Twitter integration to get me all the tweets containing the college in 6 words hashtag in the past 7 days. Disclaimer, I own the Steve C. Data platform and it's a paid product, making this sort of like an ad, but it may help you out if you need to get Twitter data for your own projects. Link in the description. So here I got almost 7,000 tweets and corresponding user information I uploaded into Google Drive. Now we can finally analyze this data using Google Colab, which lets me run this Jupyter notebook code here. If you don't know how to code, don't worry, I'll explain everything and you can just sort of follow along and say that you're learning how to code if anyone asks. Here I'm just loading in the tweets into something called a data frame, and I want to track how long it took each tweet to respond to Jimmy's initial tweet here on May 24th. Did they respond in 5 minutes or 5 hours? Because I think that will play an important factor in who gets picked. So now I'm just also loading in the users because I need to be able to find the winners based on their username and match that to the tweet so we can look up those statistics. We're also gonna look at things like count, reply count, etc. And now I'm gonna cut all the data off at this timestamp here, which is when The Tonight Show tweeted that they're about to air everything. So at this point, I assume they picked the winners by now. And lastly, we're going to merge these two data frames by user ID. So we're just going to add the user related columns like username to the tweet table. Don't worry if this doesn't make any sense, it will pretty soon. Now let's take a look at some of the tweets and order them by response time so we can see how long it took the first person to reply. So here's Jimmy's initial tweet telling people to post something with college in 6 words, and then he replied right away to his own tweet within 1 second. So he's either a fast typer or had that one prepared. And we can see the first response came in at 27 seconds after the initial tweet. So wow, that's pretty quick thinking for posting a tweet there. And we see people chime in. This one's at 30 seconds, 41 seconds, etc. And then we get the people all the way at the end who waited about 2 days. I don't know if they were thinking about it, strategizing, looking at what other people said. And here's the final tweet cutting everyone off. So my first question is, how selective is The Tonight Show? What's the acceptance rate of getting featured? So like I said, there were about 7,000 or so tweets. And I can see here the acceptance rate is about 0.1%. I'd have a higher chance of getting into Harvard. So I can see here there are about 6,700 tweets in total. Now I want to check out response time. Do the majority of people post their tweet right away after Jimmy announces the hashtag, or do a lot of them wait? Well, according to this histogram, I can see the most popular time to respond to Jimmy is right in the first hour. We have about 1,800 tweets respond to him in the first hour, and then that drops to 1,000 in the second hour, and so on, and significantly decreases after, say, the 6th, 7th, or 8th hour. It's a slight hill at hour 20 and then it just tapers off. So let's take a closer look at the first 3 hours because that's when most people are posting and see if we can find any patterns. So here I'm just restricting the data to hours 0, 1, and 2 and I can see a similar looking distribution. This is minute 0 and I can see that 10 people posted within the first minute and then that starts to go up. People start thinking about it and post right away. Then there's a peak at about 10 minutes where I guess people have had enough time to think and then it slowly goes down. I then wanted to ask, well, there's no limit on how many times a person can tweet with the same hashtag, so how many attempts do most people make? So I grouped the data by the username and got a count for each username and printed out the top 20. So this person here, I don't want to show their name, tweeted 118 times and then 87, 50, 35, so there's some people who are trying dozens of times to get featured, but they don't actually succeed in this data set at least. And we can see the distribution here. Most people just try once, the vast majority. And then a few people try two times over here, three times, four times, etc. And very few people try more than, say, 10 times. Now let's take a look at the winners and try to figure out what makes them so special. Do they have a lot of followers? Did their tweets get a lot of likes? Or is it just totally random? So here I watched the Tonight Show footage and I copied the username of all the winners and then looked up their tweets in my data set, and I can check out some of the response times and like counts, etc. And I can see a few people tried more than once, but I don't see anyone trying more than 10 times, say, so that doesn't seem to help. And it's really weird. I don't see a big correlation between like count or follower count. A lot of these people who got picked don't have a lot of followers, and some of them have zero likes, zero replies, zero retweets, etc. But you will see a few people tried a few times, so when that happens, I just cross-reference the tweet content to figure out the winning tweet, and then I need to get the tweet ID here, and then I mark them as a winner here using this function. So this just changes that column is winner to true only for my 10 winners. So now I can analyze them all together and see if they have anything in common that I may be missing. And lo and behold, when I look at the response time for all of these lucky winners, they are extremely quick to respond to Jimmy. 6 minutes, 6 minutes, 9 seconds, 6 minutes, 14 seconds, 15 minutes at the median mark. And the only exception to this rule is this person who took 1 day and 23 hours. And what's really funny is that this person's tweet got zero likes, zero replies, zero retweets, unlike some other ones that did get a little bit of feedback. So maybe that's why they were selected initially, but this one person at the end is really bothering me. How did he get picked? Well, I remember the 80,000 in his tweet is something that Jimmy used for his initial tweet when he tweeted everything out. You can see that was his initial tweet. And you can see a few other people use that $80,000 language, but not a whole lot. This is only like maybe 15 people. And that could be the reason he got picked and he posted last. So maybe Jimmy himself saw that tweet, or maybe even searched for his own tweet and saw that 80,000 language pop up, and that's what got him picked. And although the rest of the winners replied quickly, so did everyone else. So I wanted to see the median response time for the winners is 15 minutes. How does that compare to the losers? 2 hours and 42 minutes. So I think it's clear that if you want to get picked, you need to post within, say, the first 15 minutes. If you do that, you'll be within the top 9% of applicants to the Tonight Show hashtag program. And we can see again at the winners, roughly half respond to Jimmy's initial tweet within about 15 minutes, and 90% respond within an hour. So if you want to be on the Tonight Show, you need to respond to Jimmy's initial tweet within the first hour. Preferably within the first 15 minutes, as the data showed us. My guess is that the staff monitor the hashtag for maybe the first hour, and they look for the top tweets, the ones who get a lot of likes and interactions, as we saw in the data. But we also saw that a few tweets got picked that had zero likes, zero retweets, etc. So they may also just look at some random tweets, but they were all within the first 15 minutes to 1 hour. The only exception to this was that $80,000 tweet, which matched Jimmy's original language. So I'm not sure how that happened. Maybe Twitter suggested that tweet to his own account because it used similar words, or I really have no idea, but it's an interesting idea. Maybe just kind of mimic what Jimmy posts in his tweet, and that's an alternate strategy you may want to try. Let me know your thoughts in the comments below, and maybe if this can help you get on the Tonight Show, let me know if you were ever featured. Thank you so much for watching. Stay amazing and stay data-driven.